Last class, we discussed about the centralized procedure for following European Union. European Union, how the member states are there in cooperation with their drug approval processes, we have seen in the last class. And centralized procedure is getting marketing approval in all the member states by a single application, and it will be processed by a single organization. So under this MAA, that is the name of the application, marketing authorization application, will be filed with the European Union. The special organization that deals this filed application is CHMP under the European Union. CHMP is the Committee for Medicinal Products for Human Use. So they are reviewing this application. They'll normally take 210 days to give a final marketing authorization in European Union. So once it is awarded, then the manufacturer, the sponsor, can market their product in all the member states. It is applicable to all the countries. Even politically, they are different. Regulatory wise, they accept each other. This is called centralized procedure. And we have seen further that some kind of medicinal preparations, centralized procedure is compulsory. We have to apply through this procedure only. So in that list, we have seen cancer drugs, drugs for the treatment of AIDS, diabetes, orphan medicines that is used for rare diseases, autoimmune diseases. All these drugs should be approved through centralized procedure only. And that is the rule followed in European Union. Okay, we continue the further approval procedures for marketing authorization. Another procedure is mutual recognition procedure. Mutual recognition procedure allows applicant to obtain a marketing authorization in the concerned member state, CMS, other than the reference member state. That means reference member state is one country under European Union where you did a clinical trial and got approval. Now you are going to market in another country which is under European Union. So that another country is called concerned member state, CMS. The originally the country which evaluated all the processes from the beginning are reference member state. So you belongs to a reference member state and you are going to market in another country which is under European Union. Then you can follow this mutual recognition procedure. So here you will get marketing approval only in RMS and CMS only additionally. So this application is for filing under CMS. CMS will not ask the complete data, safety related experimentations to repeat. They will accept the certifications issued by RMS. Accordingly, they will also give approval in CMS. So this is the advantage of filing mutual recognition procedure. You don't want to market in the beginning in all the countries, then you can limit your area and market only in a concerned member state. This is called market on a mutual recognition procedure followed in European Union, where the drug is previously approved under RMS. The applicant submits identical dossier to all European Union member states in which they want marketing authorization, including required information. Okay. As soon as one member state decides to evaluate the medicinal product, at which point it becomes the RMS. See, suppose you did your clinical trial in European Union, but you are going to apply first time. So you are first time applying under European Union for your product for marketing approval. So at that stage, your drug is need to be evaluated That means it will not be done in all the member states of the European Union. Just one state, you will apply to all the countries under the European Union wherever you want to market. Among that countries, one country will take responsibility to evaluate your applications with various basis. Their pharmacological data, toxicological data, like that. All information, whatever you submit to the drug, that will be evaluated by one country. That one country will be called as RMS. The other countries will accept the data and simultaneously they will also give marketing approval. Those countries are called concerned member states, CMS. The application have also been submitted. The RMS issues a report to other states on its own findings. The generic industry is the major user of these kind of drug approval procedures. So instead of trade names, if you are launching your product to manufacture in the generic product, then you can use this procedure, mutual recognition procedure. This process may consume a time period of 390 days. The overall time period for this approval is 390 days. Okay, how this is taking place practically, this flow chart will explain. Mutual recognition procedure. Applicant submits application to the reference member state and the concerned member state, both the countries. The country going to evaluate your application, the country going to approve you for additionally marketing in their territory. So in both the countries, they'll file the same time. Then day one will be counted from there. Then RMS validates the application. RMS will completely validate all the necessary parameters. For that, they take 90 days. Then RMS distributes assessment report to the CMS. For example, Italy is taking responsibility to evaluate. Then the Sweden will, for example, Sweden is the CMS. CMS also will receive all the tests, evaluation procedures and reports from RMS. CMS also validates the application. Again, 90 days it will take. After that, CMS approves the assessment report. CMS is the country that is Sweden is going to give marketing authorization first time. So they will assess the report. Finally, marketing authorization in each of the CMS will be given. That means in my example, I said only one name of CMS, only Sweden name. CMS may be many countries, not only one. But RMS will be only one country. Italy will review, Germany will be a CMS, and Sweden will be a CMS, Ireland will be a CMS, so like that. Many CMS will be there. So mutual means we should not mistake that. It will be between only two. It is between many countries also under European Union, not all the countries. That is it. Okay. Decentralized procedure is another procedure of filing application for marketing authorization. Using this procedure, companies may apply for authorization simultaneously in more than one European Union countries for products that have not yet been authorized in any European Union. So far, not launched in European Union countries first time. And you are going to launch in more than one country simultaneously. So and essentially do not fall within the centralized procedures essential drug list. So essential drug list we have seen AIDS, cancer, autoimmune diseases, rare diseases, that category it should not fall under. Then such applications will be accepted. Based on the assessment report, which is prepared by the reference member state, any comments made by the concerned member states, marketing authorization should be granted in accordance with the decision taken by RMS and CMS in this decentralized procedure. Generally, used for those products that has not yet received any authorization in European countries, this is the first time approval, then we are following decentralized procedure. Here, time duration may take 2-10 days as like a centralized procedure. Centralized procedure also, first time we are applying in European country, but all the countries. Decentralized procedure is also first time we are applying in European countries, but that is only in a selected countries. Applicant submits application to the RMS and CMS simultaneously. Both are simultaneously. So in a decentralized procedure, applicants submit application to RMS and CMS simultaneously. And the application will be reviewed by RMS and CMS simultaneously. This is the difference between the mutual recognition procedure and the decentralized procedure. There, one country will review and the assessment report will be sent to another country. Here, both the countries will validate the application simultaneously. Here, after validating 70 days, RMS distributes the preliminary assessment report to the CMS. Then, after 35 days of review, RMS sends preliminary assessment report and all comments to the CMS to the applicant. RMS sends preliminary assessment report and all comments of the CMS to the applicant. The RMS will act as a mediator. That country will discuss parallelly with the CMS and then collect the inputs of CMS, and through the RMS only the applicant will receive information that what is the status of approval, what are the additional data required by CMS. Then clock stops, applicant response, clock runs. That means we are telling practically these many days. That means it depends on the response from the applicant in this stage. Suppose next day itself the applicant responds, then within 15 days the next process of review will take place. RMS sends draft assessment report to the CMS. So they will review and then final draft will be sent to CMS and also to the applicant also. After 90 days, CMS approves the assessment report. CMS also accept the review process and they will give permission to market in their country. Then marketing authorization in RMS and each of the CMS will be given simultaneously. Here also one country will represent as a reference member state. They will collect all the information and they will mediate with the applicant and the remaining countries. So this is the decentralized procedure. The only difference between centralized procedure and decentralized procedure is here one country is evaluating, there one commission CHMS is evaluating. Here only in limited number of countries in the marketing approval is given. In centralized procedure, all the countries it is compulsory given. Another one type of application is nationalized procedure in followed in European Union. So by the name itself, we understood that it is only limited to one nation under European Union. Nationalized procedure. How it is done? The nationalized procedure is one which allows the applicant to obtain a marketing authorization in a one member state only. You want to take up marketing authorization only in Spain, you can apply. In order to obtain a national marketing authorization, an applicant must be application must be submitted to the competent authority of the member state only. You should not apply to the European Commission for application approval, only to the member state, only to the Spain's regulatory authority. New active substances which are not mandatory under centralized procedure can obtain marketing authorization under this procedure. So it is not under the mandatory list of cancer drugs, AIDS drugs, then you can apply here. Timeline for this procedure also 210 days only. So the international conference. Through the international conference, on harmonization, ICH process, the common technical document, CTD, guidance has been developed for Japan, European Union and United States. So these are the regulatory guidelines followed by European Union while approving the application. Most of the countries, including India, have adopted the CTD, the common. This common technical document followed by CDSCO also has CTD format for technical requirements of registration of pharmaceutical products for human use. The same procedures are followed by European Union also. So these are the regulatory guidelines followed by European Union. And this regulatory system based on the network of decentralized national competent authorities in the member state. The decentralized procedure, it is followed by, it is the applications are regulated by national competent authorities, NCA, in the member state. I said nationalized procedure. If you are wants to apply only under Spain, then the regulatory authority of the member state only will review that application. So in each nation, there will be national competent authorities supported and coordinated by a centralized agency, the European Medicines Agency, that is EMA. EMA is like how we have CDSCO in India, US FDA in USA, in Europe we have EMA. The EMA will give guidelines how to review to the member states, NCA, National Competent Authorities. The European Union was created in the year 1995 to coordinate existing scientific resources in the European Union member states. So for that purpose, it was created, EMA. So on the EMA, an interface for cooperation and coordination of member states' activities with respect to medicinal products. So for that purpose, to coordinate and the activities between the member states, one union, one organization was developed by European Commission. So that is only EMA. The EMA scientific decisions are made through its scientific committees. Many other committees are there under EMA. The members are chosen on the basis of their scientific expertise and are appointed by the member states. So each member states will contribute members to the committees, which is one of the main role of EMA is to mobilize scientific resources in the member state. So many of its scientific activities are carried out through a large network of scientific experts made available by the member states. So all countries under European Union will jointly do this exercise to regulate the So I stopped recording at this stage.